That didn't come out right. Wait, welcome to the show. That sounds better. Okay, the show, as you know, is called Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Thank you. And of course, I am also Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Because let's face it, everybody, it's all about me. Thank you. And besides, you know, we did some research and they, you know, they found out that most of my fans can either remember my name or the name of the show, but not both. I blame the Russians. Okay, let's hear it for my Macabre-mobile. You know, we have a lot in common. We have been around together for a long time. A lot in common. We both have high beam headlights. We both had a little body work done. And, you know, despite racking up a crap load of miles over the years, our engines both purr like kittens. Hey, sound dude, when I want your opinion, what do I do? I'll beat it out of you. Yeah, thank you. Okay, let's hear it for my set. Oh, no, not that set. This set. Thank you. Okay, did you guys dig that opening number? Yeah. You know, I told my dancers that if they didn't get the moves down, there would be grave consequences. See what I did there? Grave. Okay. Oh, yeah. And speaking of graves, this year's show actually has a plot. And it ain't a cemetery plot, honey. No. It is actually about a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed actress who... Ew, God, bushy-tailed. My God, that reminds me, I gotta make a waxing appointment. Where was I? Oh yeah. All about a bright-eyed, bushy-tailed young actress who heads across country and winds up here in beautiful, sophisticated Buena Parque. Sorry. Yes. And for the three people out there who don't speak Spanish, that means good park. Yeah, thank you. As opposed to that mice-infested place out in Anaheim, you know, Parque Malo. Okay, and speaking of parks, I think it's time for me to park my assets right here on my signature sofa. Yeah, and do what I do best. Not that, you perv. God. No, I mean, come on, this thing ain't a casting couch. What do I look like, Harvey Weinstein? Just that. Oh, well, it looks like this is gonna fit four comfortably. All right, boys, later after the show. All right, thank you. Ooh, not too bad, right? Boom! Man, those dancers are sometimes harder to get rid of than herpes. Okay, now it's time for me to show a bad movie, right? Except this one is not bad. This one is a masterpiece because it's all about my meteoric rise to the middle. So just in case some of you don't know who I am and you just came in the theater, you know, to take a load off and get away from the homicide clowns, you are going to learn what you're dealing with, okay? So everybody just sit back, relax, put your legs up on the person in front of you. And let's take a stroll down memory lane. I was born at a very early age to poor white trash parents who were so old-fashioned, I wasn't even allowed to wear makeup until I was 3 months old. The 15 years I spent in grade school were some of my happiest times. But like all kids, I went through that awkward phase, which sadly continues to this day. During the swinging 60s, I tuned in, turned on, and dropped out of high school, where I was voted most likely to by the entire football team. Right out of school, I joined the military, where I served directly under General Stormin Norman Schwarzka in Operation Penny Shield. Time after time, I went down behind enemy lines, single-handedly winning the war. After serving my country, I did what any red-blooded American hero would do. No, I didn't go into politics. I went into TV, becoming one of the most sought-after thespians in the business. I said thespian. Having successfully hosted my own show, I left the roller coaster world of television for the real roller coasters here at Nuts, where I quickly became the most popular ride. Well, they don't make men like that anymore. Wow. Realizing that opportunity only gives you knockers once, I decided to display my big talents on the big screen by starring in my very own Rawbusters blockbuster.
Yes, she's got it all. She's everything you've ever wanted in a movie. A woman and a casserole.
We got us a couple more volunteers.
Great, just grab a tool and start banging.
Elvira, Mistress of the Dark.
Yeah!
As you can see, I've really been around, but don't worry, I'm still groovy, I'm still happening, I am still hip. As a matter of fact, I got two new hips. Wanna see?
Yeah!
She's a lady.
What's going on in the backyards of our fellow Americans. So you can just imagine our shock and disgust when Knott's Berry Farm, the family-friendly home of hot pies and juicy breasts, decided to disgrace our community by hiring the Halloween harlot known as Elvira, Mistress of the Dark. Time has come for the decent people of Buena Park to rise up and denounce this overly made-up man-eater, this tart-tongued trollop, this jiggling Jezebel with junk in her trunk, and all that makeup she wears. But relax, my dear couch potatoes. There is no need to polish your pitchforks or light your torches, for I, Buffy Molding, and my army of morally superior filth fighters are taking care of everything. Oh, and the great news is that it all coincides with our annual book burning and pancake breakfast. So we're really multitasking. Get her, boys!
Talk less of the bird. You play with fire and it's perfect.
the ditzy demon with the double D's. We can all breathe easier knowing that the evil Elvira has been internally and expertly exercised. Isn't it great how when it comes to the battle between good and evil, things always seem to turn out the way they're supposed to?
I'm a volcano just ready to blow. Look out, y'all, 'cause here I can go.